Alexa, what's the time?
Hey. It's 3:03 p.m.
I'm shaking, drinking all this coffee. These last few weeks have been...
Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Natalie. And today I thought it would be nice to talk about college, you know? Just to talk about college. And I am currently a junior in college. So I wrote the tips or advice down on my phone. If I'm being real, this is my third time trying to film this because the first time I didn't like how I was talking. I was talking so low that you could barely hear me. The second time I tried filming it again yesterday, but yesterday I was in the car. I was gonna turn it into like a drive with me, but we're having like technical difficulties. So, but that's on me. I need to start being more open to the camera, you know? Also, this bright light is like flashing in my eyes. Okay, I have 10 tips that I would give to anyone who starting college or maybe transitioning schools. Okay. Advice number one, I put to make friends, and this is extremely important because
you need people who are gonna grow with you until you die.
I think making friends is important in college because like these people could be with you for the rest of your life, you know? And can you guys even hear me? Alexa, play some music.
Here with Spotify.
Making friends in college is important because like these people can motivate you with classes, push you to become like a better person, and plus these people can be with you for the rest of your life. For example, I've made like my freshman year of college, I've made a friend, and we've been like friends ever, like we're still friends every day. We currently have a Snapchat streak, and she's number one. Yeah, she's my first best friend on my Snapchat. Okay, advice number two is don't procrastinate. This is so hard, but it's hard not to do, but like it happens to all of us if I'm being real. Oh my gosh, I don't wanna do this because it's so dumb. How is it gonna help me in the future? If you procrastinate, like, it's terrible, especially in college because teachers really don't care about like your other classes that you're taking. Like, it's up to you to balance every other class, and like if one teacher gives you one assignment one day and another teacher gives you another assignment the other day, like at least start on it or like try to plan, because if you procrastinate and you get it done late, if you rush to get it done, A, it's gonna be a bad job, and B, like, your grades matter in college, so like, no, don't do that. Don't procrastinate. Bottom line, excuse me. Tip number three I have is to stay focused. I wrote, this isn't high school anymore. You're going to be getting your life together and begin building your career, which is true. I know, especially in college, like I know there's like always parties, things and banks. What are those things called? Distractions, yeah. There's always distractions. Everything will be fine. What is this video like? It's a hot mess. I wrote, organization is key. This is true in college because you need organization to know what the fuck you're doing. It'll help you with your classes and it'll help you especially for your grades and everything. It'll just help you. I have this board behind me. I bought it to help me stay organized, because I would write my classes on top, and then I would write down when we have a quiz or when we had a test or study day or when something was due. And a tip, I would say when your teacher makes the syllabus available, I would say you should automatically print the syllabus or just read the syllabus, because I know most people do not read the syllabus, if I'm being honest, because I didn't do that my first year, but you should read the syllabus because it has all the important dates on it, period. But apply for scholarships. This is true, especially if you're starting off at a four-year university. Me, I just, after high school, I just went straight to a community college, so I didn't really need a scholarship. But I'm in the process of, I'm going to transfer, for the spring semester, and I need to start applying for scholarships because universities are not cheap, especially, if you're going out of state, that is not cheap, that is expensive. So apply for scholarships. Don't overload yourself with classes. This is extremely true because if you put too much on yourself, you're just gonna end up being stressed the whole semester, and then that can downfall or downplay, and then you'll not get good grades. But I know some people can do it, me, my first year I did 12. I think it just depends on the kind of person you are. If you're going to take hard science classes like anatomy, biology, chemistry, don't take those all in 1 year or in one semester. Balance it. Maybe 1 year you'll take biology with an easy class English or something. You know what I mean? Just mix it up. And don't overload yourself or overload your schedule. Unless you need to, don't buy, but write your textbooks. This is so true. I was so mad my first year. No one told me this. I would recommend renting your textbooks instead of buying it, because renting, it's much cheaper. You don't really keep the book after. You're just borrowing the book. The websites I usually use to rent textbooks is Chegg. I know Amazon does it too, so. Or ask a friend who took a class that you're taking. Ask them, did they save the book? Just saying. Talk to your teachers and counselors because they're there to help. This is extremely true because I know going into college, you have literally no idea what you're doing. They know. They're there to help you, so if you're having trouble to try and decide which class you want to take next semester or what path you should do, they are there to help you. And plus, I would say even if you're if you go visit them frequently and make a connection with them, they can probably write you a letter of recommendation. Next tip I have is to set goals. I know there's a study that says if you set a goal, if you write down the goal you have and you physically see it in front of your face every single day, it'll motivate you to do that goal. If you set goals, you'll get everything done. And setting goals is just gonna push you to get it done. Once you get it done, you'll just feel happy with yourself. You'll be wow, I really did it. Then my last advice is to have fun. It's college, you only get to experience this once in your lifetime. make every semester count, but remember, don't get too carried away. You're in college, you're like basically on your own now. You're basically on your own now. And it's like your time to find out about you. So, just have fun.
90 degrees and a low of 74 degrees.
Thanks, girl. Peace, love, happiness.